everyone, Raid a dashing one, boy. Hope everyone had a great Monday. Hopefully, all the dashers, well, all the gig workers earned a few quid. Hopefully, made it worth your while you were out there. Didn't seem like it was a bad day after all, but I didn't get started until late. But I suspected that was the way it was going to go. If you watched my video that I finally posted earlier today sometime, I had a rather late night delivering. I think it was like 4:30 in the morning. Started at 5 o'clock Sunday and finished at 4:30 on a Monday morning. It was a long shift. And I'd switched from Lee Summit, being at Lee Summit, and Lee Summit finally slowed down a lot after when Taco Bell was closing. So then I ended up in Blue Springs after that, and saw that it was a bit busy over there and was curious. I needed to get some petrol, and somehow or other I ended up in Blue Springs. There was a, oh, that's right, because where I'd gone, I was going to head home, but at some stage, you know, after Taco Bell had closed, but and I thought, you know, there was some offers coming in from Blue Springs, and I went, shut it, I'll take it. So I went over there and got some petrol and got started over there, and yeah, it was busy. Got to meet some other drivers tonight, though. Like I said, I didn't get started till late. Actually, I just looked back. 7 o'clock. Don't know how comes I got started that late, but anyway. But anyway, after last night's fiasco of rather long shift, rather, not so much a fiasco, but it was a rather long shift. I had to wait for someone to come out and repair the water heater today. And so I had to stay awake because there was no time. There was no time for said to that they'd be here. So I fell asleep in the chair, which really isn't much of a sleep to be fair. I should have slept in the bloody van. It would have been a lot better. But they finally made it at 2 o'clock. Got that sorted, and I got some. Did I turn over? I thought I turned Uber off. Oh. Said I just got a tip. Nice. Anyway, so yeah, I got about an hour and a half kip after that nap. And then we went out. Got something to eat. And off to work. But anyway, yeah, it was an interesting night. We didn't do a whole lot. It wasn't a catering order, but it was a one from the Mint. Went over to the Mint tonight, and it was fairly busy. It was like a DoorDash driver convention. Although there was a couple of people picking up for the individuals and that. Actually, there was a couple in there, a young couple in there, when I first got in there, because we went into the part where you, in their little part where you go and pick up window. They haven't got the restaurant open as of yet, but they're getting it. Anyhow, so I go in there, open up the door and go in, and the young fella, he was there, like, on his phone, and then he jumped. Good grief. Like, shit, mate. I said to him, blimey, I didn't think I was that scary. Jeez. He said, oh, I saw you coming in. He said, I don't know what. I said, bloody hell. I said, what? Then you saw me face, isn't that when you jumped? Like, jeez. Anyhow. Oh, it was quite funny. And we had a little bit of a chat while we were there waiting. Nice young couple. And Well, I'll take it over a couple, I don't know. But anyway, two young people there. And anyway, and then some driver came in, and another driver came in, and then another driver came in. I was there for a little bit waiting on my one. Don't know what went on at the Mint tonight. Something odd. But anyway, finally got out of there. Met with had a chat with a couple of drivers there, and then a bloke that I've seen in there. He's seen me around there several times because he only lives around the back, so he's in there quite often. So he's used to see me. I forgot I've got my iPad in there. And anyway, so went off and delivered that, and that went to Independence, to a house that we've been to several times. I looked it up on the map and went, oh, all right. I know exactly where that's going. So I took the motorway this time. Normally I just go up Lee Summit Road to this one because it's more direct. But I just went a quicker route, a lot quicker. Plus it's going up 291 and down I-70 to get to it was a lot safer on the van, because Lee Summit Road, vipping out by the caves, or even before. I mean, Lee Summit Road is absolutely diabolical. You hit one of those flipping potholes and you're going to rip your bloody suspension out. Absolutely diabolical. But anyway, so I went off and delivered that, and then my wife had reminded me earlier on, not too long earlier on, that, oh, I need to go see a British friend over there, because they'd been and picked up something for me while they were out shopping, and picked up some British snacks. If you're not vipping seen it, if you've not had these before, hot cross buns. Hot cross buns. And look them up on Google, whatever. If you're in the area and you want some, they're an Easter item, and absolutely bloody delicious. And I think they're only like 5 or 6 quid for a tray of them. And go over to World Market, not World Market, I lie, Whole Foods over in Brookside, apparently. And just go over there, because they got some there. Just don't run them out, because I might want some more. But anyway, they're really good. In fact, my wife liked them when I got them the last time around, or when I collected them the last time around. I don't do a lot of shopping, but this lady, she goes shopping quite often, and so she goes there a lot, and she picks them up not only for us, but she picks them up for several other British friends that are in the neighbourhood. And then also, when I was over there picking up, I'd go say hello to a little dog called Toby. Yeah, I put Toby's picture up. I didn't take any pictures of him tonight. He was so bouncy again. But anyway, I put pictures up of him. Lovely dog. Can't believe that someone vipping. He just wandered up to their house one day, and she'd done all that she could to try and find the owner, and he wasn't chipped or anything. She's had him years now. She took him to the vets, got everything. I mean, he went to the right house, because she's rescued several kittens, helped them find homes, has paid all their vet bills and whatever, and she does a lot for the animals. And this little doggy fell on his feet, that's for sure, because he certainly gets loved there, that's, and spoiled. But he's a lovely little dog. Alright, so tonight, weird night, very weird night. Got some absolute bloody dipsticks on the road, that's for sure, tonight. And some idiot in, I don't know what, some crappy looking flipping wannabe flipping sports car like a manky old flipping Honda that had been trying to turn it into something decent, but they'd made an absolute, made it look like shit, basically. Looks like that sounded like they straight piped it too, so it. Anyhow, the damn thing was up my flipping ass, flipping going down Chipman Road. I was off to Chipotle too. Anyway, I flipping beeped it as it went past and flashed me lights at it. Then I see it turn around. It was okay. I was getting ready to deal with it. And, no, it pissed off somewhere else. But it was absolute idiot drivers. And then I had another one a bit later on that was somewhere like that. And then, you know, it weren't all that busy anyway. While we were waiting for a job to come in, and went over to IHOP, parked at the between IHOP and Andy's, and just waiting for anything to come in, sat there quietly, and there seems to be like entertainment in this place, and there were some kids that flipping over there in dancing over at Andy's, right on the thing underneath the lights in it, and they were pretty bloody good, to be frank. If you ever seen like Cossacks, that's it, Cossacks, Russian dancing, but I think it's more to another area of the Russia at the moment, but anyway, well, hopefully it won't be part of him, but anyway, anyhow, it's an old folk dance. So yeah, they were dancing away. I didn't actually get that on camera. I pulled up the camera, and by then they were all vipping, going a bit crazy then. I mean, they were doing all right when they were bouncing around doing it out there on the forecourt of Andy's and under the lights and that. But then they got a bit flipping stupid. I don't know if they were on something or what, because then a couple of them vipping got on top of, hopefully, their bloody car. Well, they got in and drove off in it, but anyway, later on. But they were on top of the car, vipping, dancing, and then stood on the boot lid and dancing. It's like, what the hell? If your parents had bought that car, then... Wow. Well, even if they haven't, they got no respect for the vehicle, so I'm going to guess that they didn't actually pay for the bloody thing. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if they've flipping stolen the bloody thing. But, and then they ran over to Five Guys and that. I'll put the video here, but somewhere at the end. I'll put the video at the end. And, yeah, absolute flipping idiots. Turned out to be idiots, but they seemed to be alright when they were just doing it outside there. I mean, they were really bloody good at it. And I said to my wife, I said, oh, that reminds me of a song. And I went and found it. Rasputin by Boney M. Go look it up. And anyhow, they were just in the midst of leaving and in the midst of leaving, and then an offer came in from Uber Eats, paying pretty bloody well, only going 2 miles apparently, and it was coming from Chipotle across the road on 291. Well, I don't often go to Chipotle. In fact, I normally avoid the bloody place like a plague, but I had been to one Chipotle earlier on, the one off of Chipman Road. I don't know why their address is Chipman Road, because they're not really on it, but anyway. So I'd been to that one and delivered that actually to St. Luke's Hospital. So anyway, went to the one on 291. It was like, well, bloody hell, it's a bit late, isn't it? Don't they close at 10? Anyway, I got over there. Well, it looked like they were cleaning up. They were. But this offer had only just come in, so I don't know. So anyway, I get over there, and I wasn't sure the bloody place was unlocked, but the door was unlocked, so I went in and I stood at the thing because I see the girl there, doing a mopping and that, and I didn't want to make too much of a mess, what she may have just done. And then some flipping noisy, absolute horrible fucking piece of shite that flipping works there came out shouting and screaming out of the kitchen area, trying to vip and have a go at me about vipping. Oh no, we've vipping had 3 people coming here, 4 people. No, you're the 4th one coming in here about this. We don't know about this vipping order. I mean, she was going into one. Which really vipping got my back up straight away, so vipping, I was off. So she learned a bit of English lingo then. Absolute foolish. So,
drive to highlighted route.
Now the bloody GPS wants to talk. Brilliant. Anyhow, so I turned around, pulled out of there, vipping marked that has already been picked up. Probably won't get anything for that, but I only had to come from across the road, so it didn't really matter. But I would say that that vipping Chipotle probably will still remain on my not bother to go-to list. They do have these idiot managers at times, or people that work for these places. But unfortunately, there's a lot of people that don't want to get their asses out of work anymore. So they get what they can get, I suppose. So anyway, that was really it. No, that wasn't actually. Another offer came in after that, and that was from Hawaiian Brothers. I went and parked back over by Andy's. And as I was on my way to park the van, Uber went again, and it's for Hawaiian Brothers going off of Wishchapel Road. Been up this road many times off of Wishchapel there, and anyhow, it was an easy drop off. Actually, the geezer was stood outside out on his driveway when we got there. So wife handed that to him, and I turned around, went back down the road and said, I think we should go home. Because it was easy shot to straight to go home from there. So that's what we did. But yeah, I don't know. Very interesting night. I would have expected tonight to be more of a Saturday night type of thing, Friday or Saturday night craziness, but I don't know. And I'm still not sure kids are on spring break and we're experiencing some of the foolish ones that are out. That thing to pick some supposed pickup that was supposed to be from Chipotle. The screaming, flipping banshee, flipping in there, bloody well, had said I was the 4th one in there. Well, why the hell have we got 4 drivers coming here wasting their bloody time listening to you? When, what's this happening? Anyhow, when I came out of there, I made sure to mark it that it had already been picked up. So I just left it at that. But yeah, definitely the screaming banshee for sure. But other than that, no, I mean, there's nothing really else to say. I mean, like I said, I don't know whether we're on bloody spring break or not, and we've got the flipping idiots that we've got out to deal with. Or is it just too many idiots flipping, being allowed to flipping, go on drugs a lot easier now that the government are flipping, taking a haircut? It's all okay now. The flipping go on drugs just because the government are making a mint out of it. But it's a pity that they wouldn't put some of that bloody money back into doing the roads bloody properly. type of, or putting more police on the road if you can stop these bloody clowns that are out here driving like they're on bloody drugs. Anyhow. But no, other than that, no, it was a, I didn't know what to expect on a Monday, but, you know, I did get started late. I was stupid in that fact. I should have foregone flipping going to get something to eat and just had that later on. Well, I didn't. So tomorrow is due to be the day that I want to go out and do Walmart Spark. If that actually happens, then great. If I've... But I really do need to get on to do that. Unfortunately, I seem to have got a bit of a noise on the front of the van. It's a bit worrying me now. I was going to pull the wheels off to check the brakes and that, but I looked through the wheels the other day, the gaps in the wheels, to check the pads. It didn't look like they were that flipping far down. But it's a bit difficult doing it on the ground with one little fat flipping bud not being able to bend down that far. Plus the day I could barely walk, let alone flipping bend down that bloody far. So I need to get it on a ramp and have a look at it. Or just send it down to the garage and see what they flipping want to charge me. I'll play them on my light. If you haven't got one of these yet and you're a new subscriber to the channel or watch my channel, then need to get one of these. If you're a delivery driver or you take the dog for a walk or you just go for a walk in the mornings or the night time or you go out hiking or whatever, you know, this is a good thing to have. Yeah, I know it's a torch and maybe you don't need it if you've been hiking unless you're doing it late at night or early in the morning, but it has a little toy to it and it's rechargeable too. Where is it? If you haven't seen it, I've done a video YouTube thing on this before, video review. It's a bloody thing to recharge. Anyhow, you plug it in there somewhere and I lost the little bit where you hold it, but anyway, good torch, very good torch. Lasts for flipping weeks, this, on a single charge. But anyway, if you turn it on there, turn it there, and then turn it there, and then the sound will go down a little bit after this, so you don't have to adjust your sets. But this will give someone a bit of a light. Always good to have one of those. I showed it to a couple people tonight, actually. They're on Amazon. In fact, I'll put the link below again and the link to the video review that I did of it. I got it because, you know, I was out in some precarious areas and up some flats and such that were that didn't have lighting on, and was out there in the elements trying to vip and look for houses. And I don't know why they didn't have lights on the outside, but didn't seem like they were going to get repaired anytime soon. And then of course with the added the bonus of having the taser part, I mean the noise is enough to vip in liven people up. In fact, it livened up a few people tonight, those that I showed. Told them to be warned anyway, but and I was just showing it to them. I wasn't about to use it to them, but anyway, yeah, it was you need to have some protection, that's for sure. Definitely need protection of something to liven them up. I mean, even if you've got a mad flipping squirrel trying to attack you. Yes, I've had one. Or a bloody rabid dog trying to attack you. Yes, I've had one. Even if he was on that vipping tied to that post. he was ready to get off of that post and have me for dinner, that's for sure. And it wasn't even to the house that I was bloody well delivering to. That was way, way in the beginning when I first started DoorDashing. Always know your areas too. Always be aware of where you're going. Don't just rip and pick up an order. Just don't go, oh, there's a good pay an order and go click. Especially on DoorDash. And I say especially on DoorDash or Grubhub. And I say, the other reason I say especially is because you can actually zoom in on where those orders are going to, where those offers are going to, rather. They're not an order until you say yes. So as soon as it comes in, look at where it's going to. You know where you're picking it up from. You have an idea. So to zoom in on where it's going to and figure out if you want to go. Don't have to take a bloody order for crying out loud. It's your car, it's your body that's going to get mangled if something gets wrong, goes wrong. So if you don't feel safe in doing it, going to that area, don't do it. Simple as that, just don't do it. And the other thing is, if you've got someone that will go with you, have someone that go with you. It's always good to have someone to keep you company or whatever whilst doing all this mad stuff. And although bear in mind it's going to be two of you wanting to go to a loo, so you're going to be maybe doubling up on visiting Quick Trip or whoever. Always take snacks with you. I haven't got one. There's one, it's in the back. I've got a little snack thing that's about a bigger than this, about this wide. It's got a screw-on lid plastic thing, and you can just put some crackers in it. In fact, if you like them goldfish things, what I do is I actually go to Dollar General. Go to Dollar General. They got these things next to the goldfish in there. And they're called whales, about the same size as the goldfish, oddly enough. But they got them in this blue box with the orange flipping whale in it. Should be the other way around, I would have thought. But anyway, blue whale. And anyhow, they're only $1 for this box. I normally get a few of those boxes, whack them in the thing, and I've actually got one indoors too. And then it's just something to snack on. Because I guarantee if you're out there delivering pizzas or something that appeals to your belly, the smell of it ripping is going to get you at some stage. And I don't know, it might make you feel a bit peckish or something. Just pull over, Fippy, and have a few snacks or something. Preferably not with someone else's food on board. But when you're done with them, and then when you've done that, always get yourself, always have some of these in the car. Get some hand sanitizers. I mean, you can get these ones with the lid on it. You can get, these ones are actually quite flipping big. I don't know what size that is. And it doesn't matter what the bloody thing label says, because I mean it's going on your hands, but it's not like you've got to dip your hand in, fingers into someone's food. But anyway, get several bottles of those, go to Dollar General, they're $1, any of those ones. And you know, you just got to look for your local on that one. And yeah, I mean, just, and maybe pick up some napkins and some utensils too, because some of these people, they don't think about asking for that. And when you deliver it, they might be at work, they might be at home flipping, just moved in or something, and don't have anything to wipe their hands on. But or they're doing the building work, wherever you're delivering to, and they need this sort of stuff, you've always got something there that the restaurant hasn't put in there. So if they ask, you got it. I did have it in the other van, but I got to relocate some straws and more napkins and some utensils too. In fact, I mean, if you go to Dollar General again, you can buy the bloody, I know it costs you money, but at the end of the day, it might get you a better tip. Give some people some. But, I mean, if the restaurant don't put it in there, it saves you a bit of earache. And you turn around and go, oh, well, I've got these. And you can buy flipping, like, packets of these flipping things at, well, Dollar General is what I'm going to, this is about the only shop I ever go to anymore. But I know you can pick them up at Walmart or any bloody way, I'm sure. And just find the cheap art section and pick them up. Keep them in your vehicle, just in case. Just in case for someone else and just in case for yourself. And like I said, always take a snack with you, definitely. And drinks too. These. You know, you can pop into Quick Trip or any of the shops when you're on your way and get bottles and bottles of flipping drinks, but they're going to cost you, what, $1.60, $2, depending on which one you get. These, I don't remember how much. Can't see how much because it's too flipping little, but anyway. You can pick up 24 of those for about $5, $4.50, $5. Pretty much anywhere, I think. So, you know, just pick one of those up, stick it in the back of your vehicle. I've got one in the back. And actually, I'm about halfway through it or more. And that way you've got a drink. And if someone, again, where you go needs a drink, they haven't ordered one, then at least you got that. You might be able to sell it to them and make a few quid. I don't know, but anyway, it's a good idea to have something like that. Being that it's coming up to the warmer weather, no doubt soon, you might want to get a little cooler for yourselves and stick it in that.
Drive to high.
Or plug in a mini fridge in the back of your car. I can do that. I've got a inverter that's with the van. Actually, why is that off? That should be off. And yeah, I mean, you can plug that in. There's all sorts of ways. I mean, if you're intending on doing this full time, your ass is going to be on this seat a lot of flipping hours. A lot of hours. You're going to be in the vehicle a lot of bloody hours, so you're not going to be at home a lot. So bring some home comforts or whatever you want, and make yourself comfortable. You're going to be here a long, long time in the vehicle, so you might as well make it to your benefit and have something that you might even be able to make some money on. Sell some drinks and such. And if you, like I said, if you've got the utensils and the napkins and such, they're not going to be individually wrapped, so whoever you give them to is going to have to flip in like it or lump it. But they should have bloody ordered their own. But at least you got something that might even make you a bigger tip or an extra tip, whichever. Anyway, at the end of the day, I think I'm done. So if you enjoyed the video, hit a thumbs up if you would. And hit the subscribe button too if you would. Apparently all of that helps the channel grow. And also hit the bell icon too. That'll warn you when the new videos come out. And I try to do it on a daily basis. I try to do it at the same time every day, but that doesn't seem to work too well. Apparently Google like it if you put it out the same time every day. Well, I'm sorry. I can't always do that. I mean, I can schedule it, I suppose, but in the meantime, I've got to edit all of this. And normally editing means put pictures on. And also, if you're interested, I do another channel that I started called, and it's all about doing vehicles. Everything to do about cars. Cars, trucks, whatever. And I've got about 25, I think, vehicles to do reviews on at the moment. I've done a review on a Jumpstart pack that's on there, which someone liked actually. They went out and bought two of them. there's a few other things I've got. I've got this charger thing to do, and yeah, there's other stuff. And there's other stuff that I want to get to, so. So anyway, that one, by the way, is called Agent Auto. And I'll put a link for that below. And I'll put the logo to one of these sides. All right, anyway, thanks for watching, and hope you have a great week. All right, thanks again. Cheers. Ta-da.
Of hidden charms.
So he was paid.